All right, so let's talk about exclusions now. All right, so we're still talking about the net cost, what's included, what's not. So so far we've been talking about when to use net cost versus when to use transaction value, right? Now we talk about the inclusions. We kind of saw briefly inclusions and exclusions when we saw the table, right? Remember that Boots example? So here, the net cost we talked about includes the sum of all costs that go in the production, but excludes sales, promotion, royalties, shipping, and packing. Now, once we're going to solidify that knowledge by going more into the details. And the details are as follows. So it includes all costs that go into production, we saw that already, but it includes marketing stuff. And marketing stuff includes marketing costs, including personnel costs, rebates, such as merchandise incentives, insurance, notice, product liability and property. Those are the buzzwords, folks. Keep this in mind. Product liability and property insurance. And then D, payments by the producer to other persons for warranty repairs. So other persons, I should have probably highlight, underlined it, but there's too much highlighting. So keep in mind, this is also a key event which must not be included. And of course, as the saying goes, for each rule, there is a customs broker exam question. So examiners have asked, which one of the following is not a sales promotion marketing or after sales service cost after NAFTA? So this one, sales promotion marketing and after sales service cost, is a term of art, right? It excludes sales promotion, sales and after sales service costs. So this term of art includes all this stuff. So examiners really, from the, again, we're still in the appendix, part 181. Examiners here are testing you on this term of art, which is includes all these elements. So as always with the laundry list, we must go through the list and take out those ones that do not apply. We are looking for the one that is not. So retailer and wholesaler rebates are part of this sales promotion, marketing, and after-sales service costs, which are excluded, right? We have general liability insurance, general liability. So what's excluded is only product liability and property. General liability is not excluded. So B, and since we are looking for one that's not, B so far fits the bill. Payments by the producer to persons for warranty repairs. Other persons. Is straight copy and paste example. Marketing director's salary here, it would be marketing personnel costs, right? Because marketing director, right, is a personnel, it's an individual who gets paid for the job. But personnel costs are excluded, therefore the director's salary is also excluded from the net cost value calculation. Free samples are also excluded from the net cost because it's part of the marketing scheme under the storm award. This means general liability is our answer choice.